Former police officer Derek Chauvin has spent his first night in prison as crowds across Minneapolis celebrated his conviction for the murder of George Floyd. And just hours after the verdict, the US Department of Justice launched an investigation into the city's police force.
A new day and a new commitment to upholding George Floyd's legacy. The place where he took his last breath, now a respite for quiet moments of reflection.
We have to make sure that our hearts are big enough to embrace differences.
The first sign of real change. The US Justice Department launching a sweeping investigation into policing in a city where many have died at the hands of officers.
The challenges we face are deeply woven into our history. Building trust between community and law enforcement will take time.
Congress vowing to push ahead with tough police reform.
True justice will not come until we finally banish the ancient poison of racism from the American soul.
Banished to prison, Derek Chauvin, the former police officer, spending his first night behind bars in maximum security and on suicide watch. His legal team has 60 days to appeal the verdict, widely welcomed, though some questioned whether the jury was impartial.
Everyone understood perfectly well the consequences of an acquittal in this case. After nearly a year of burning and looting and murder by BLM, that was never in doubt.
People have come from all over America to be here, but those initial feelings of relief and celebration have now been replaced by a steely determination to take this moment and make it a movement.
Australian Justine Ruzcek died after being shot by Minneapolis officer Mohamed Noor in 2017. And tomorrow, the city will grieve once again with the funeral of 20-year-old Dante Wright, fatally shot by a white female police officer at a routine traffic stop. In Minneapolis, Alison Petrowski, Nine News.